Sports sponsored by your Oklahoma Ford dealers.
And hello, my friends.
Before he ever stepped foot in the Sooner State, little Alan Jerkins, as his family knew him, had a soft spot for Oklahoma.
I wasn't the only Mickey Mantle fan, but
no.
I was obsessive. No. Like when you had social studies and you did a project, I did it on the state of Oklahoma because of
right?
Mickey Mantle.
Since 1934, there was a baseball park here.
The son of a Hall of Fame horse trainer in New York, Al came to Channel 2 in 1979 as a young reporter, gave TU Hoops great Paul Pressey his nickname.
And I just happened to be going to the game and that song comes on the radio.
Uh-huh.
That's probably my claim to fame in my whole career here is that I actually named Paul Pressey, the rubber band man.
Now that the steroid issue has died down just a little bit.
After stops in Wichita and Nashville, Al became the sports director at KJRH in 1986.
I mean, what do you think the headline will be this time? Sooners are back.
In the 31 years since, he's reported on national championship games, Final Fours, and Super Bowls.
Well, that wraps it up for now. We'll be back with more Super Bowl.
He's covered some of the all-time greats.
Tulsa thought they had him, but Barry Sanders wound up in Stillwater.
But he's also featured little pros.
At attention, folks.
And taken us for numerous trips into the highlight zone.
Submitted for your approval, the unusual, the bizarre.
As for that nickname,
Big Al Jerkins, the most trusted name in Oklahoma sports for
it came from his predecessor, Jerry Weber, nearly 40 years ago. How could he possibly have known how perfect the moniker would be?
Is this a tough sport?
A big guy.
The first thing you said, one time, I think he might have been a left tackle. You know, he's got great feet, he can move, he's got the size and the length.
Three, hop, hop, hop.
Yeah! With a big personality.
He walks into a room. And he owns the place.
He's a spark and full of life and funny.
All right, TU will finish its season. I lost my seat again.
Whoa!
The biggest sports fan you'll ever meet.
Yeah! Come on, Mike! Hang on, baby! Hang on, baby! Yeah!
But mostly, it's that big heart.
That was one of my favorite things, to go somewhere with Al, not to a game, but to go grab a hamburger at Claude's and see how he interacted with everybody. He loved everybody, and everybody loved him. And it wasn't fake, it was absolutely genuine.
31 years, the longest run for a sports director in Tulsa TV. The reason for that popularity, the reason for that longevity. Well, you heard it at the start of every sportscast.
Hello, my friends.
You know, when I open up and I say, hello, my friends, I mean it. I really do. The folks who've been loyal to this station and our sportscasts, I can't tell you enough how much we appreciate that. And you've made my life great.
This is Al Jerkins in Miami, Florida. We'll take a trip down memory lane.
Al Jerkins' Oklahoma ties started in his childhood. From his first day at Channel 2, this Yankee fan was thrilled to be in the state where his hero grew up.
I hop in a car, I go to Commerce, I take my pictures, I get my picture in front of where Mickey Mantle practiced. You know, the whole nine yards, and I was in 7th Avenue. Even when I was a kid, I rooted for Oklahoma in football before I even knew there was Oklahoma was a state.
To Al, Oklahoma is a great place to cover sports.
So on Friday nights, we got the best high school athletes. On Saturday, we have the best Division I football. And on Sundays, we got the Cowboys or the Chiefs. How does it get any better than that?
Through his years at KJRH, 34 of them, he's interviewed top coaches and star athletes, sharing the best highlights with Channel 2 viewers who know him on site, but don't call him a celebrity.
Maybe I've hung out at the job longer than most, but I like to think that's because I worked hard and did the right things for the most part. And work with some great people that helped me out.
Let's get an interview out here now.
Hard work and long hours are what made him start thinking about retirement. He hosts a radio show 5 mornings a week, then works 2 to 11 here, plus long weekends covering football.
JT, our longtime photographer, and I would leave Tulsa at 5 in the morning for a 12 o'clock game in Dallas.
Covering the game and editing highlights add up to 17-hour days.
My age now, it's really put a strain on me, so.
When he can, he flies out to watch his grandkids' games.
And then it really hit me. What am I doing? She's only going to be this age for so long. And I've got 7 grandkids now. So I just said to myself, I've got to be with my family more.
That's when Al made plans to retire. He'll tell you he works with the best, now and back then.
Miss him dearly. Still do.
Like Jerry Weber.
He taught me how to be an Okie, because when I came here, I was the run all over the place and bounce off the wall New Yorker. We got to do this, we got to do that. You know, and he'd say, take it easy, we'll get it done, you know, everything will be fine.
And the news tonight, local
Keith.
New at 5.
Russ McCaskey.
He had the perfect hair, didn't he? Holy cow, he had the perfect hair. Obviously, I'm going to miss you dearly. Miss everybody that I've worked with. Miss JT, Kerry Griggs. Those are the guys that, you know, he kind of grew up in the business with. I miss that big time.
You're so lucky.
Oh, gosh. Incredibly lucky.
And grateful to viewers like you who made his long career possible.
And I hope they know that I was loyal to them. So I really was. I try my best every single day.
Now he's looking forward to the next inning.
I mean, I'm going to go to the games anyway. Trust me, my schedule is going to be full when I retire. Full. But I will miss the post-game chatter. I will miss the diagnosing each play. I will miss that part. There's no question. How can you not? I mean, like I said, it's like being in a candy store. And, you know, just have to go on a diet from that, I guess.
For Big Al Jerkins, life is good.
Thank you, Oklahoma. You know I love you. Thanks to Mickey Mantle, I really love you. No, I appreciate it.
This is Al Jerkins in Miami, Florida. We'll take a trip down memory lane.
Well, I thought everyone knew that Lady Bird played basketball.
She did. I'm sure she did. One of these days, you can call her Johnson. You don't have to call her Johnson, whatever. But Lady... Larry Bird, maybe you've heard of him.
Here in Wichita, at Wichita State, when they had football, their coaches said they didn't need another shrimp in their backfield. Nebraska, they didn't give a second look. Oklahoma asked him to visit Norman, but Sanders declined. Tulsa thought they had him, but Barry Sanders wound up in Stillwater.
Gallagher-Iba Arena is one of the smallest arenas in the country. Yet, if you took the entire population of Bryant Reeves' hometown, multiplied that by 20, brought them in here, you'd still have empty seats.
See a difference in that, can't
you? Yeah, you can. In age as well, yes. I'd call Larry Holmes the overweight champ of the world, but George Foreman has that title. And at age 40...
This is Mike Sell, Dane Dudley, responsible for these cartoons, parody on baseball. Mike, you're responsible for the editor.
You're going to have to get a whole lot of tickets for folks in Tulsa for Pasadena?
Yeah, I get a few people. Just the ones that... It stuck with me. I'll find out who my real friends are.
There used to be a goalpost right here. But OU officials have 3 weeks to replace this goalpost. OU does not have a home game until then. They're on the road against Baylor and Texas A&M the next 2 weeks. But goalpost or no goalpost, there's no doubt OU will be number one in the morning. Reporting from Norman at Oklahoma's 31-14 win over Nebraska, Al Jerkins, 2 News, NBC Sports.
And welcome back to 1-1, and with us, Carl Malone, recipient of the Henry P. Iba Award. And Carl, thanks for being with us.
Thank you very much.
All right, let me get it out of the way. Your thoughts about the NBA Final Championship Series.
Your boxing career, when you look back at it, obviously it wasn't as successful as you may have wanted it to be. You made your mistakes, you made some money at it. How do you look back at your boxing career now as a whole? Were you glad you got into it? Was it?
To be honest with you,
all right, we'll have more on that throughout the week, of course. Now, the marquee matchup in baseball tonight taking place right up I-44 in St. Louis with the Atlanta Braves visiting the Cardinals. Let's go to the highlights and check it out. And we look at the highlights, and that is Tulsan Charlie.
People are surprised that when November comes, the end of November, that you're not just goofing off until February. You know, I think people are like, well, golly, you have an off season. You don't have to do anything.
You don't play golf.
And they really, well, I'm terrible at golf.
Oh, okay.
They really don't understand how much work's involved.
Go to our kids, team of the week.
Welcome back to Sports Extra, and joining us now, Pat Jones. Pat, welcome again.
Okay.
The banquet circuit is just about over. It's time to crank it up again.
Yeah, it really is.
Well, that wraps it up for now. We'll be back with more Super Bowl post-game activity coming up on Sports Extra. Now back to Keith.
How long have you been doing this?
12 years.
Well,
This will be number 13.
That's 13 NBA seasons if he can find the energy to play again.
You can go back to high school, so I owe a lot to James Taylor.
Obviously an illustrious career. When you came back here at Oklahoma State,
it took a while for my eyes to get adjusted. So used to seeing you in the Sooner colors. What were your feelings like the first time you went out on the floor as the Cowboy coach?
I like eggs. It was a big day for Charles Barkley, first off.
All those guys. I mean, I know, and I've been around a lot of sports folks, as you have, but when I meet a guy that, you know, is almost kind of like a hero kind of a thing or whatever, I got a little choked up at first. Was it like that for you to meet Jerry Rice and Steve Young and those guys?
Well, at first, I mean...
Coach, I got to ask you, the criticism that you went through last year as head coach of the Cowboys, how did you do it?
Well,
how did you deflect all that criticism?
First of all,
I mean, a lot of guys couldn't handle that.
You got to consider the sources. First of all, you know, Dallas has 4 million people, but they have a Randy Galloway and they have a Dale Hansen. Those guys attacked me 20 years ago.
All right, TU will finish the season. I lost my seat again.
Whoa! The chance to have its best record since 1991. The Golden Hurricane, a 13-point favorite.
Jeffrey, thank you very much. TU wins the early start game by 10, 73-63. Tulsa winning its seventh conference game, its 11th home game. Creighton losing its fourth conference game. Let's pick up the highlights.
Okay, Jerry, good crowd here at the Canes Ballroom. I don't know how to explain this. This is mud wrestling. 10 seconds left to go in this match, so let's go right to it, okay? Go ahead. Okay, 10 seconds left in this match. Go ahead. You're all set. Let's see who's going to win this one. The girl on the bottom is leading on 2 points. Here we go. The redhead needs a takedown here. Let's see what happens. She can't do it. Let's get an interview out here now. Are you glad to win? What? Is this a tough sport? They're busy wrestling. Back to you, Jerry.
Five or something like that. It's great. I can't believe it. Those people out there believe in us. This is what it's all about, man.
And obviously, well, you guys traded ideas and obviously learned from each other. What was that relationship
well,
like?
I think the relationship was always real good.
So the season concludes as Tulsa basketball's most successful ever, 32 wins, 5 losses, and just 5 points shy of their first ever appearance in a Final Four. It was not, however, a satisfied Tulsa locker room.
Come on, someone get his ass open.
Yeah!
When it comes to digging hard for a story or going that extra mile, News Center 2 sets the pace.
That is story number one, and that's it for another year. In just a few days, we will have a top 10 story, the next OU football coach. Who will that be? The mystery continues for another week. Thanks for being with us, and Happy New Year, everybody.
And the Rose Bowl. Folks, this is the site for this year's national championship game. But a lot has to be determined by then. We have all of fall to get those things straightened out.
Yeah, but you know, we'll all be sick of the icky shuffle.
Si in the control room.
Yeah, Si, what's up?
There's something you need to see in here.
All right, I'll be right there. I don't know what this could be about. What in the world do they want me in the control room for? Something happened? Uh-oh. What's going on, fellas? All right, baby.
Yeah.
All right! Everybody's doing the icky shuffle. Be there.
Get out of here.
All right, I'm going. Get it. All right, I'm coming. Hey, everybody's doing it. All right. All right, I'm going to give it a shot. One, two, three. Hup. Yeah! Back to Beth.
Finally, Gary Gibbs got that Longhorn disguised as a monkey off his back. Finally, OU beats Texas in the Gibbs era.
Laura, thank you very much. This ball game has national championship implications for the Sooners, and how long has it been since we've been able to say that? Now let's take a look. If OU beats number 2 Kansas State and then goes on to beat number 1 Nebraska in a couple of weeks, the Sooners will be right in the middle of the thick of things. As Oklahoma and Florida State players enjoy the warmer climates and the sights and sounds of Miami, Florida, getting ready for this year's Orange Bowl and the championship game, Al Jerkins, 2 News, NBC Sports.
You're watching 2 Works for You at 6.
A final salute to sports director Big Al Jerkins.
It's the most trusted name in Oklahoma sports.
Now, after 34 Let's years on your television back. Screen, he signs off NBC for the last sports. Time.
He has the longest continuous run of any sports director in Tulsa television history.
They're here at the airport, ready to greet the team home.
Tonight, we dig deep into the 2 Works for You vault to find Big Al's best stories over 3 decades.
Are you glad to win?
I think he's as dyed-in-the-wool Okie as any of us.
Let's go to the highlights and check it out. And we look at the highlights, and that is Tulsa and Charlie.
People are surprised that...
Go to our kids' team of the week.
Welcome back to Sports Extra, and joining us now, Pat Jones. Pat, welcome again.
Okay.
The banquet circuit is just about over. It's time to crank it up again.
Yeah, yeah, it really is.
Well, that wraps it up for now. We'll be back with more Super Bowl post-game activity coming up on Sports Extra. Now.